must have left my house at 8 because I always do. My train, I'm certain, left the station just when it was due. I must have read the morning paper going into town. And having gotten through the editorial, no doubt I must have frowned. I must have made my desk around a quarter after nine, with letters to be read and heaps of papers waiting to be signed. I must have gone to lunch at 12:30 or so, the usual place, the usual bunch. And still on top of this, I'm pretty sure must have rained the day before you came. I must have lit my seventh cigarette at 2:30. And at the time I never even noticed I was blue. I must have kept on dragging through the business of the day, must have shut a part of me away. At 5 I must have left, there's no exception to the rule. A matter of routine, I've done it ever since I finished school. The tube back home again, undoubtedly I must have read the evening paper then. Oh yes, I'm sure my life was well within its usual frame the day before you came. Chinese food to go. I'm sure I had my dinner watching something on TV. There cannot be a sitcom or a game show that I've never seen. I must have gone to bed around 10:15. I sleep so much these days, I need to be in bed by then. Or maybe I read a while, the latest one by Declan Gunner or something in that style. It's funny, but I had no sense of living without aim. Turning out the light, I must have yawned and dreamt my way through yet another night. And rattling on the roof, I maybe heard the sound of rain.
I love the rain.
The day before you came.